Next important thing when you have finished all of these is sowing the seed, the medium. The medium I would swear by that have seen a lot of success is coco peat. Only coco peat, just use coco peat and nothing else for germination, and it can stay up till about 1 to 1.5 months with just coco peat. When you're sowing seeds, it's also important that the medium does not have any fungus in it, because fungus is one of the main reasons why your root rot happens and the seedlings die. So to prevent root rotting, you have to add some antifungal powder. You get even antifungal liquid. So Trichoderma viridi is a pro fungus. It kills the bad fungus that's there in the soil and it makes your plant grow healthy. Right now I've run out of Trichoderma. So with coco peat, you can actually mix a little bit of this Trichoderma powder and put it in this. You get SAF fungicide though. Copper sulfate is also one that is antifungal in nature. Some people dip their seeds in copper sulfate or SAF fungicide and then they sow. All of them work as long as there's some kind of an antifungal agent there that will prevent root rotting. Because let's all agree, we are all a little bit obsessed about overwatering our plants. I'll come to that point later. So when you do overwatering, root rot is one of the common things, and when there are fungus in the soil, the medium, it will affect your plant. So antifungal is very important. You fill your seed tray with coco peat. Once that is done, you have to sow your seed. Before sowing your seeds, it's very important to know which seeds require light to germinate and which seeds require darkness to germinate. So there are certain seeds, okay, like calendula, vinca, and there is one more, I can't think, I think daisy. These seeds require darkness to germinate. I currently have this issue. There is one row that has vinca. Germination rates are very poor in that because they require darkness to germinate, and I had put them all together in seeds that require light to do. So you can understand my predicament. I couldn't do anything. I should have covered only this area with some kind of, you know, an opaque object, or just kind of keep this in a dark area. You cannot do that. So I made that mistake. So please don't do that. Research about the seeds before sowing them together. Their requirements for germination, that is light and darkness. Once that is done, then you can sow them together. When you finish sowing, label them and keep the entire tray either in darkness or in light. Next point is, all seeds require moisture to germinate. So if you have a greenhouse, well and good. If you don't have, you have to create such a kind of an atmosphere where moisture is retained. How do you do that? By covering the seed tray with a plastic sheet, by putting this in a plastic sheet. After you've put water, there's already water, either your coco peat already has water, or you slowly sprinkle water on top of the seed tray. Ideal rule is, you know, let the medium already be wet, because these are seeds and they will not get dislocated. The next question comes to your mind is, how deep I have to sow? It depends. The rule of thumb again is twice the size of the seed. The depth of the sowing must be twice the size of the seed. Now you have various kinds of seeds, various sizes of seeds. So let's say you know how zinnias look, you know how dahlia seeds look, they're slightly long. You also know how marigold seeds look. So twice the size of the seed, the depth must be twice the size of the seed. Is don't take like the length of that and then put them all the way deep. The best way I have found to sow seeds that are flat in nature is by laying them flat itself and very, very lightly cover the top portion with the same medium, that is coco peat. So this has worked for me. Next comes seeds that are extremely tiny, like Celusia cristata, Celusia plumosa, coleus, petunia, and you know the likes. They're extremely tiny. So those seeds can just be sprinkled on the seed trays and you're done. You don't have to cover it with anything else. You know, all these you need to keep in mind to have the best germination rates and for your plant to grow. I did not have these. I made all these mistakes and I kept on, why it's not germinating. Did a lot of research and then read a lot of blogs and watched a lot of YouTube videos, and then it suddenly occurred, oh my god. After reading it, I learned that okay, seeds also have this condition in